principles of inheritance and variations principles of inheritance and variation. So in the given heading, the word inheritance, what is inheritance? What is inheritance means, just you remind one thing, elephant, baby elephant. Baby elephant origin from or arise from mother elephant. Mother dog given birth to puppies. Like from mango seed to mango plant can originate. It means from one generation to next generation, the similarity of same type of species are originating. How? Human being to human being, animals to animals, fishes to fishes, plants to plants. How it is going on? How they are originating? Principles of inheritance and variation. What is inheritance? Inheritance indicates the genetic transformation from parents to offsprings. For example, elephant, baby elephant come from the mother elephant. Puppies are originated or formed from their parents, dogs. Like from mango plant to mango seeds to mango plants are come. It means human to human, fishes to fishes, frogs to frogs, plants to plant. How they are originating, how they are forming. How they are forming means there is in the form of inheritance. What is inheritance? Inheritance is nothing but of transformation of parental characters from parents to offspring, generation to next generation. They are carried by some particular factors, they are called genes. Okay, so the inheritance means transformation of genetic information or genetic characters from parents to offsprings. Then you take variations. What are variations? Variations means differences. So differences are parent to offspring differentiation. Among the offsprings also there are differentiations which are come from the same parent. Even though they are come from the same parent, they show the variations. It means they show the differentiations. For example, you take brother and sisters or two brothers which are come from one parental family. Even though they are coming from the single family, they show some variation. Few are long and height, and one boy is very short, his hair is gray and another boy hair is black. Like they show the variations. So the variations are differences which are between the parents to offspring, and among the offsprings which are come from the same species also show the variations. So the variations may be morphological, cytological, behavioral and physiological. So not only variated in the morphology, so they come in the variation in morphological, cytological, physiological and behavioral variations. But here the topic is principles of inheritance and variations. What these are, what are the principles explaining the process and mechanism of inheritance and variation. These two are included in one biology branch of biology that is called genetics. The word genetics given by the scientist Betson, and the word genetic popularized by the work of Mendel. Who is Mendel? Mendel is a scientist. Mendel is genetist. He born at 1822 and he died at 1884. Who is Mendel? Mendel means Gregor John Mendel. Grigor John Mendel. Who is he? He is the Austrian monk. Austrian monk. He conducted the hybridization experiment. Hybridization. Hybridization experiments. He conducted the hybridization experiment. He selected for his experiment, that is pea plant, that is garden pea, that is Picum sativum. Picum sativum. So he approximately 8 years he spent for his experiment. 8 years of time spent for his experiment. Hybridization experiment. Total his experiment he given and he published in the one paper. The paper is called Experiments on Plant Breeds. Plant Hybrids. Plant Hybrids. So total his experiments volume he published in experiments is published in the title of Experiments on Plant Hybrids. What he conducted, what type of experiment he conducted means he conducted the experiment of hybridization experiment. The hybridization experiment completely depend on to artificial crossing, also we said as selective crossing. Based on this phenomena he conducted his experiment. For his experiment he selected the plant, that is pea plant, that is garden pea, that is Picum sativum, belongs to the Fabaceae family, and it shows some unique character. Because of that unique character he chose that plant for his experiment. What are the unique character shown by the pea plant? The pea plant is commonly short-lived plant. It means it lifespan very short. Lifespan is short. It means within the month it completes its life cycle. That's why very short lifespan it have. And it is here the self-pollination and cross-pollination possibilities are more. It means favor for self-pollination and cross-pollination. Favor for self-pollination and cross-pollination. Next, easy formation of seeds. Easy formation of seeds. Okay, based on these characters he selected the variety, that is the pea plant, for his experiment. Completely he conducted his experiment 8 years. Out of 8 years, 2 years are spent for pure line production, and he spent for true breeding. What is true breeding? How the pure lines are produced? True breeding means it is a breeding for continuous generations. It means the plant go to give, the plant can give the pure lines. How the pure lines are produced means there is a generation to generation, the continuous self-pollination that can result to pure line formation. Sometimes we say as homozygous. It means the pure line means most of the or majority of the parental character are transmitted into the high plants that are called pure lines. Pure lines consist majority of the parental characters. For pure line breeding, he carried out the true breeding experiments. True breeding experiments means there is a continuous of self-pollination for selective breeds or selective plants. Then only he got the pure lines. After 2 years of work, he got pure lines, then carried out the hybridization experiments. During the hybridization experiment, artificial crosses are taken, as well as selective breeding he conducted. Continue. Pea plant, garden pea. So he selected the garden pea plant. Going up. Garden pea plant for his experiments, hybridization experiment. So what happened in hybridization experiment? Hybridization experiment, they are controlled crossing. Here, the crosses are made under control of Mendel. So what are the controlled condition? For his, the garden pea plant is, the flower is bisexual flower. Bisexual flower means both anthers and gynoecium, both are present in the single flower. That's why they are called bisexual flower. So, bisexual flower, how they are variated from the pistillated flower and staminated flower. But he, for his cross, he selected the cross over cross pollination. So cross pollination means here is a two flowers for seed germination. How means here the bisexual flower made as unisexual flowers. How? Unisexual flowers means male flower and female flower both are separate. So the female flower is called pistillate flower, and whereas male flower is called staminate flower. Okay, from bisexual flower, for his experiment he prepared the unisexual flower. How he prepared? So here he followed the one procedure, that is emasculation. So what is emasculation? Emasculation is nothing but of removal of stamens from bisexual flower. For example, you see, this is the bisexual flower. The bisexual flower consists, here stamens are present as well as stigma is present, and these are the petals and sepals. Okay, so here the stigma is present. So this is the style, and this is the gynoecium, and these are the stamens. When the stamens are removed, what happened? Only the stigma is left. Stigma is left means the bisexual flower is converted into pistillate flower by the process of emasculation. Okay, here he received one plant and another one is staminate flower. how he select the staminate flower. So staminate flower is bisexual only. Why? Because here the stigma is inactivated. Stigma is inactivated. In what condition will be it can inactivated means? So here when the pollen is dusted onto the stigma, then only the cross pollination is going on. But here to avoid cross pollination, contaminated cross pollination, here the stigma is inactivated. Hence the bisexual flower is become unisexual flower, that is staminate flower. So for this, for making for the staminate flower, he protected the flowers by bagging. What is bagging? The flower is completely covered with polythene bags to avoid cross pollination through air or water or insects. Okay, so then means inside of the flower is protected from the cross pollination. Okay, then only the experiments are conducted. You see here on the stigma flower or staminate flower. So on the staminate flower, first he collected the pollen grains and dusted onto the pistillate flower. So he collected the pollen grain from the staminate flower and dusted onto the stigma of flower. So the stigma of flower means, the pistillate flower means, it do not having any stamens, only stigma is present. When he dusted the pollen grains here, there is a cross pollination is going on. So that can be resulted into seed production. So to avoid contamination of other cross pollination, after the artificial crossing, he made the flower by, he tagged the flower by the bag. So that is bagging. He followed the bagging technique. Okay. Then he received the seed production. So what type of seed, what he expected, the desired characters are he taken, that consisting seed is produced during hybridization technique. It means selective parameter consisting seeds are produced. Okay, here the seeds are collected and he go for the propagation, and he germinated in different stages, and then he observed and he recorded the experimental approaches. Okay, the results are recorded in the form of, so here the results are interpreted, the results of Mendel experiments interpreted by using of mathematics as well as statistics. It means the biology is applied into the mathematics and statistical. It means what are the interpretation, what are the results he got from his experiment, that are interpreted by using of the statistical mean, mode, statistical values. So the first time statistical introduction is made by the scientist Gregor John Mendel in his experiment, especially hybridization experiment.